Kavita Krishnan makes two important points. One, this is a small village. Virtually every family knows every other family. Just because the boy and girl know each other, we don't specifically know, because the number is registered in the victim's brother's name. So we don't know specifically whether the girl was in touch with this number, but there were calls exchanged. And even if we were to assume for a moment that the boy and the girl knew each other and they were speaking to each other, it doesn't mean that he couldn't have tried to force himself on her, because just talking to someone doesn't mean that you won't try and rape that person.
Yeah, I think Rahul, Kavita has a fair point, but I would also say that for many people, no is not a no. And for many people, speculation is also a good ideation point. Now, if we skew this entire investigation into one side, I don't think it will be justified right now as yet for us all to jump to conclusions. Kavita ji has her point, but then Shantanu makes a very pertinent point.
What does no is not a no mean?
So,
just elaborate on that. I didn't get that. What does no is not a no mean? I don't get that. What?
Kavita ji, I was saying that for many people, no is not a no. So rape may exist even while they have a relationship or they have a friendly relationship. I was trying to support your point that you were making.
No, but Shantanu Gupta, one second. How fair is it in the middle of a probe, which A, should have been handed over to the CBI, for the Uttar Pradesh police to put out these call records? Because they're obviously put out with the intent of creating a specter of confusion. People will wonder whether this is to put out facts or to try and spin a new narrative, because the original story, in the way that it appeared, seemed to have hurt the professional prestige of the Uttar Pradesh police. Now they're trying to cover their backside.
No. First of all, so I think why will it create any narrative? SIT, anyway, any inquiry is not based on narrative. CBI inquiry is not based on narrative, and the case will go to the court. It's not available. It's not based on any narrative. But yeah, when I'm sure police also has a communication team. From last many days, we were saying, oh, police is not managing the communication well. A lot of media is peddling, a lot of news. We have their phone records, how media is coaching, tutoring the son, the brother to give a particular kind of video. We are hearing 25 lakh, 50 lakh. So media, police is also giving their kind of story that, okay, this is the fact that we are finding and we are just sharing with you. This is giving you day by day update. What is the problem in that?
Shantanuji, I want to ask you something, since you seem to be speaking on behalf of and in defense of the government. How much money has the UP government paid the Concept PR agency?
Telling what I heard in Hathras yesterday.
This media narrative management, the spin management, how much have they paid the Concept PR agency? I'm really interested in knowing. Since you are a hagiographer of Yogi, maybe you know that. Can you tell us that?
You gave a three minute social gyan, which means nothing. Come to me in Hathras, let's go tomorrow. A kid can tell you what.
I know Western UP well. I know Western UP well. You're not the only expert.
No, but Shantanu, if you go to a village.
How much are they paying the PR agency? You don't appreciate my social gyan, never mind. I want to ask you, as a hagiographer of Yogi, can you tell me how much has the UP government paid the Concept PR agency to do what you just said they are doing, which is attempting to manage the media narrative? How much have they paid the Concept PR agency?
Out of taxpayers' money.
Can you tell me that?
I can recommend you a good English tutor. I think you have a problem in comprehending. I said police is just giving daily level of news, daily level of updates.
I'm just asking you, do you know how much the UP government has paid the Concept PR agency?
Okay, one second. I can't allow this conversation to degenerate. We're dealing with... No, one second. Both traders go down. We're dealing with a very, very sensitive issue. We cannot and remember, we're in the middle of the probe. And it is my firm belief that we run a newsroom. We don't run a courtroom. We don't believe that we are judge, jury and execution. We will report on the facts as they emerge. We will report on the facts no matter how inconvenient, no matter who likes them, who doesn't like them. If these call records have been put out, it's a fact that needs to be reported. What it establishes, what it doesn't, can be looked at, discussed, assessed and analyzed. But it's not something that can be kept away from the reportage. But here's the point. And that's the point that Shantanu Gupta needs to respond to. If you have just four lower caste houses, families in one particular village dominated by the upper caste, and if an incident of this nature happens, now think of this not as Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru or Chennai, but as a small village in western Uttar Pradesh, is it not only natural that you will see a backlash from the upper caste who will come together and want to make it seem as if their boys were not at fault. And that's something that you need to keep in mind, because you have ultimately before you the dying declaration of the girl, which post Nirbhaya, according to India's new amended rape laws, is of evidentiary value in a court of law. You cannot dismiss it, Shantanu Gupta.
For sure, it has a legal validity, but it should also match with the circumstantial evidence. If Ramu, one of the convicts, is found quite away from the location and his CCTV camera, and India Today a reporter has only talked to the factory owner, I think circumstantial evidence should also match with the dying declaration. There is a high possibility.
So is she a liar? Was she lying?
No, Kavita, please. Kavita, one second. If somebody speaks when you're speaking, you won't like it. One second. Kavita Krishnan, this is not fair. You want to have a civilized conversation. Let Shantanu Gupta complete his argument. I will come to you for a counter. Shantanu.
Please, just 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds, right? There is a high possibility, on the pressure of the brother and the mother and the family and the local politician and the Bheem army, that a girl might have changed her statement. There is no rocket science in that. A 20-year-old girl, as you said, not quite empowered, can very easily change her statements on the coercion of the brother and the mother or any other family member or any other politician. If you go in the house, if you ask any other question which is uncomfortable to the family, the 5-6 boys will come here. What are you asking? And when you ask, who are they? They're some Bheem army. Bheem army people are protecting the narrative sitting inside the house. Go there and try yourself.